Item sets assemble and organize chosen items into a more easily accessible location within Omeka S. Creating an item set is similar to adding an item. Click on the plus sign to the right of the word item sets under Manage Resources on the installation dashboard within the admin dashboard. When adding an item set, the first thing to do is to select the base resource template. The base resource template utilizes Dublin Core metadata. If you would like further information on metadata, visit the DCMI website linked in the SDSU's Omeka S tutorial site. To access the Omeka S tutorial site, just like logging into Omeka S, search exhibits.sdsu.edu from any web browser. Then select the Omeka S tutorial site among the published Omeka S sites by SDSU. Returning to instructions on how to create an item set, it is important to note that SDSU requires created item sets to select the Dublin Core type collection when selecting the class value of any item set. When filling out the item set's metadata, keep in mind the grouping of items that will be added to the item set. For example, this created Omeka S Tutorials item set will hold any media about Omeka S Tutorials that the creator of the item set designates. Therefore, any metadata added to the creation of an item set should pertain to the prospective Omeka S Tutorial items. If you wish to better understand the Advanced and Tags tabs, visit the Creating Items video located within the remaining Omeka S Tutorials videos published by this YouTube channel. Always remember to select the Save button on the top right of the screen to complete the creation of an item set. To add your items to your created item set, click on the word Items in either the installation dashboard or the navigation bar. This is a page holding all of SDSU's created items by every SDSU Omeka S user. It is known as the Items page, a place where a pre-existing item can be edited at any time. To guide the Items page into highlighting only your items, click on the link at the top of the screen called Advanced Search. From here, you can control the search parameters to certain settings. The one we will utilize is the seventh search category called Search by Owner. By clicking on the drop-down menu next to the words Search by Owner, there is a list of SDSU Omeka S users. Find and select your username. Then, at the top right, click the Search button. From there, you should be brought back to the Items page with only your created item showing. To edit an item, select the pencil icon to the right of the item you want to edit. From here, select the Item Sets tab within the row of tabs at the top of the screen. If you want further information about what the other tabs represent, visit the Creating Items video located within the remaining Omeka S Tutorials videos published by this YouTube channel. On the right side of the screen, your previously created item set should appear. Select the item set or item sets you wish to designate to this item. Remember, item sets are an organizational tool and do not link the grouped items into any form of editing capabilities. If you no longer want this item in a selected item set, click on the red trash can icon to the right of the item set while editing your item. It is best practice to discuss with other project colleagues to determine if an item should be created with a link to an individual item set, or to have one person's role be the creation and connection of items to the designated item set. Always remember to select the Save button on the top right of the screen to update any changes made.